Hi everyone and welcome. Today I'll be showing you a monster that I've created that will specialize on creating top ranking keywords. The platform that I'll be using is N8N, and the name of this monster will be SEO Frankenstein V4. I'm still updating it, but if you'd like to use it, please do so. So what it will do? So it will check for keyword suggestion based on the keyword that you will put. It will get the primary keywords based on SERP data. It will scrape as well the internet for relevant data. It will get the Google search volume, and also it will get the parsed SERP. So all of these functions right here, they're required for our keyword and summary insights agent that will get all the relevant data to create our agent. Then afterwards, we're going to have a next agent that will generate the outline, then the drafting agent, and then the EEAT agent. By the way, the EEAT is the specific format that now currently in the present day Google requires. All the articles will be human friendly and so on. I'm going to have a fact checking agent that will make sure that, hey, everything is well done in a way. And of course, the final editor agent right here. So, yep, let's start. We'll start with the on form submission to be exact. Here we can put shower filter as an example. You can put anything you want, of course. Next, you need to choose your article type. Here, I'll choose a blog post. Keyword, I want to go for shower filter. Notes, how hard water affects skin, and here. Yeah, just a note as well. So I'm going to press on submit. And now our automation starts. First, it created the reference code that will be used here in our Google Sheets. In this case, it's 4, 5, or whatever. And then it will start scraping the internet using the DataforSEO servers, because it has all the tools. And it will add for us all the relevant data. As you can see right here, it's a mess, right? So that's why we need here the keyword summary and insight agent. So from this mess, it will just get all the data, all of this crazy data, and it'll create the article. Oh, it'll phrase it in a way properly so the outline agent and all the other agents will understand exactly what to do. So as you press right here, it's executing the node. It has all this input, as you can see right here, the Google search volume, the parsed SERP, the rank, general keyword data, primary keywords, and yep, keyword suggestion. It has quite a big system message, system prompt, and also user message. And here it provided as well for us all the required details so we can proceed with the blog post. Next we have our outline agent that will create the outline. So as you can see here in the user message, it has all the required details. So it has the context, the one that we filled. Also we have the date, a few notes, and also the analysis data, which is from the keyword and summary insight agent. And of course it has a system prompt that will guide this outline agent to create the desired outline. So as it's executing, it's getting the data. Currently, we are using the Gemini 2.5 Pro. So here is the output that we have. So we have a fully generated outline that is required to create a good blog post, right? It's applicable to articles, to newsletters, and to anything else. Next, we have the drafting agent that will create the basic draft based on the research done by the keyword and summary insights and also by the outline agent. So as we enter right here, we can see as well the prompt for user message, right? So here is the outline, here is the keyword and summary insights, and also we have our context right here. And of course, we have a system prompt that is guiding the agent to create the relevant blog post, right? So here we have the category, which is blog post. Here we have shower filtration, and of course, any other relevant data which is required for the drafting agent to create the draft for us. So as you can see right here, it created a draft. Next, we are moving to the EEAT agent. Very important, because as per Google, we do require people first, people friendly articles, right? And here we gave the draft. Here we gave the keyword summary and insights. And again, the context window. And also we have, of course, an advanced system prompt right here that will guide the agent to create the specific EAT friendly format of the blog post in this case. So as it's executing right here, The reason as well why we used Gemini 2.5 Pro is because, well, it's a large context window and it's a lot of tokens, right? And yep, Gemini is quite smart in this case. It can get a lot of big data, and yeah, it helps create the blog post just perfectly done in a way. Oh, there's an arrow here. So as you can see right here, it's still generating our blog post. I gave him here specific instructions, how to apply the EEAT format, what is it about, and so on. And as it's generating, yeah, we can wait for a bit. Okay, so here it is. We have an output, so show our filter benefits, why experts recommend one for better skin and hair and reduce chlorine exposure and so on. So it requires all the relevant data in regards to that. This is amazing. This is really amazing. It has a lot of data, which will be beneficial for people. The article will be top notch. It will be people friendly and anything else. Next, we're going to the fact checking agent. So here it will check that, hey, all the information given here, there's no speculations, it passes the check, so it's the police border in a way. So as we enter right here, you can see here the user message. So we have the markdown from the EEAT agent. Also, we have the keyword summary and insight. So we are always keeping reminding him that, hey, use these keywords, right? In regards to the system message, again, it's an advanced system prompt right here. What sort of data he should input here, core tasks, and anything else. You can check it afterwards if you like. It is a lot of data, by the way. So currently the fact checking data is checking the EEAT agent data. So it checks that, hey, everything is correct. You pass, or maybe you don't pass in a way. Or if you don't pass in this case, it will fix all the required stuff which needs to be fixed. So as you can see here in the output of the fact checking agent, it has checked the data and then updated all the required details, so it will be factual, right? So it will not be like water, or it will not be like irrelevant data, which we don't want, right? We want people to be informed about that. We want it to be people friendly. And of course, we want it to be factual. So next, we're going to the final editor agent. So the user message for this agent right here. So we have the original EEAT generated blog post created before by the EEAT agent, right? Then we have the fact check draft right here. And also we have the original outline. So the final editor will gather all of this data and will analyze and will make the final edit. And again, here, the system prompt, you are an expert content editor and proofreader. You define written content to ensure it is clear, concise, grammatically perfect, and yada, yada, yada. So it has, again, a good system prompt that will help him execute this blog post, right? So then I'm going to have an HTTP format request that will generate for us a document in regards to this blog post. So here, the last one is insert the document in Google Sheets. So as you can see right here, if you go to the next page in Google Sheets, here we have, okay, the reference code. We have the article topic that we wrote before. We have the article type, which is a blog post. We have the keyword, which is shower filter, the notes, and here is our exported document. So as we press on the file, let's try to open this file. Okay, so let's see what it made. So here we have shower filters benefits, why experts recommend one for better skin and hair and reduce chlorine exposure. So it created all of this blog post. It created this amazingly super well made article that of course will rank top. Currently I'm still updating it, so it will add as well reference links, but there you have it. Ladies and gents, here we go, a 15-page proper blog post that will rank high in Google. And yep, there you have it. I hope you like it. I will post everything as well down in the description below. Have a check. If you have any questions, just write a comment. I will try to answer. And maybe I'm going to try to, maybe next time I will make an update and I will share with you a better one. But for now, thank you for watching the video and have a great day ahead. Bye-bye.